Hello all, welcome to the second part of the video on objective questions to crack competitive exams. If you didn't see my previous video, I will give the link in the description box. Please visit. Let's get started. The first question is, the current in the RL circuit shown below is given. The value of the inductor given here is, to find L, we have to know the total impedance of the circuit. The total impedance is nothing but Z equal to V divided by I. V is nothing but 200, we will write in the polar form, angle 0 degree, divided by I is 10 angle minus 45 degree, or Z equal to 20 angle 45 degree. It is in the polar form, that is R theta form. We have to write in the rectangular form to find the value of L. So how we can convert this into rectangular? That is R cos theta plus JR sin theta. So we can write like this, 20 cos 45 plus J 20 sin 45. When we substitute the values, we will get Z equal to 10 root 2 plus J 10 root 2. This is the value of the impedance. It is in the form R plus J omega L. We have to find the value of L. So compare the imaginary values. That is omega L equal to 10 root 2. From the question, omega can be written as omega is equal to 5. So L equal to 10 root 2 divided by 5, or L equal to 2 root 2, or L equal to 2.828. So this is the value of L, Henry. So in the RL circuits, the current begin to flow through the circuit but does not rise rapidly to its maximum value. So this is because of the presence of self-induced EMF within the inductor. Next question is, the silicon dioxide is used in ICs because, what for we are using the silicon dioxide in the ICs? It has, it prevents diffusion from the impurities. So it acts as a diffusion mask, which permits selective diffusion into the silicon wafer. So apart from that, it serves as an insulator. It serves as an insulator on the wafer surface. It acts as an active gate electrode. In MOS device structures, it is used to isolate one device from the another. Another important factor to know is silicon dioxide layer is formed on the surface of a silicon wafer by thermal oxidation at high temperature. Next question is, the transmission line of length and having a characteristic impedance of 50 ohm is terminated with a load impedance. The impedance seen at the input end, that is ZI, is asked. We have a formula, ZI is equal to Z naught square divided by ZL. Here Z naught is given as 50 ohm, ZL is 400 ohm. When you substitute this value in the formula, you will get Z in equal to 6.25 ohm. Okay, this is the answer for this question. Another important thing you should remember is, the transmission line is exactly one half wavelength, then the input impedance is equal to the load impedance. That is, when L equal to, that is length is equal to lambda by 2, then Z in will be equal to ZL. When the transmission line is 1/4, that is lambda by 4, then Z in will be equal to 1 by ZL. It is the inverse of ZL. Okay, this is the important factor to be memorized. Next question is, the overall decibel voltage gain of a multi-stage amplifier. Here the question is asking the decibel value. The overall decibel value will be equal to the, answer is, the sum of the decibel value voltage gain of the individual stages. That is, the overall decibel gain. Overall gain is equal to what? A1 into A2 into A3. That is multiplication of the individual gain. When you convert it into decibel form, the overall decibel will be equal to A1 in dB plus A2 in dB plus etc. So the overall decibel voltage gain is the sum of the decibel voltage gain of the individual stages. Okay, next question. A function in the Laplace domain is given by f of s. Its value by final value theorem in t domain is equal to. So according to final value theorem, limit t tends to infinity f of t equal to limit s tends to 0 s into f of s. Okay, so this is the formula for the final value theorem. When you apply limit s tends to 0 in f of s into f of s, so yes, when you substitute f of s value here and simplify, you will get s into s plus 6 divided by s into s plus 3. Then when limit s tends to 0, it will be equal to 2. That is, limit t tends to infinity f of t equal to 2. Here it is. So this is the answer for this question. An expression can be reduced to. To reduce this expression, you should know about the two theorems, that is De Morgan's theorem and the involution theorem. According to De Morgan's theorem, a plus b the whole bar equal to a bar dot b bar, or a dot b the whole bar equal to a bar plus b bar. And the involution theorem is a bar of bar equal to a. So this theorem should be known. Now we will simplify this one. So a b bar the whole bar plus dot a bar of bar dot a b the bar. So it is nothing but a b dot a. Again we can apply De Morgan's theorem here, a bar plus b bar. So a dot a is a. So a b into a bar plus b bar, a b a bar plus a b b bar. So a bar when we applied theorem here, it will be 0 0. So the answer is 0. The value of the total potential difference created between the electrodes when the cell is not connected to an external circuit is known as, when the cell is not connected to external circuit, it is known as the electromotive force. Okay, so electromotive force is nothing but the electrical action produced by the non-electrical source. Next question, the two capacitors of 80 microfarad, 50 microfarad are connected in series when 200 volt at 50 hertz are applied across the series circuit. The maximum energy stored in the circuit. Here the two capacitors are connected in series with one voltage. Okay, C1, C2. So first we have to find the C equivalent. C equivalent is nothing but C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2. So when you substitute here, you will get C equivalent equal to 30.769 microfarad. So when you substitute C1 equal to 80 microfarad, C2 equal to 50 microfarad, you will get C equivalent equal to 30.769 microfarad. Now we have to find the maximum energy stored. Maximum energy stored is nothing but half CV square. So here V represents the peak voltage. That is nothing but half 30.769 into 10 power minus 6 divided by V is nothing but 200 at 50 hertz. So 200 root 2, that is, it is given in the RMS, we have to write in the peak voltage. So when you substitute this value, you will get E equal to 1.23 joule. The question is, the Laplace transform of a function on f of s, the value of f of 0 will be. So it is nothing but we have to apply initial value theorem. So according to initial value theorem, limit t tends to 0 f of t equal to limit s tends to infinity s into f of s. Okay, so it is nothing but f of 0 equal to limit s tends to infinity s into s plus 2 divided by, when you simplify this one, s square plus 4s plus 104. Then limit s tends to infinity, when you take s square outside, it will be 1 plus 2 by s divided by s square take outside, 1 plus 4 by s plus 104 by s square. When you apply s tends to infinity here, this term will become 0, 0, 0. So remaining we will be having 1. So the Laplace transform for this function when f of 0 is equal to 1. Next question. A 4 ohm resistor is connected in series with a 10 millihenry inductor across a 100 volt 50 hertz voltage source. The impedance of the circuit will be. So here R and L are given. R and L are given. We have to find the total impedance. Z is nothing but total impedance is nothing but R plus j omega L. Substitute the value here. R is nothing but 4 plus j omega is nothing but we can write 2 pi f, that is 2 into 3.14 into f is nothing but 50, L is nothing but 10 into 10 power minus 3. So when you simplify this one, you will get 4 plus j 3.14. Okay, we will see some more objective questions in our future videos. Till then, stay connected.